We know there are many choices in internet radio, and the staff and host of LA Talk Live would like to thank you for choosing the internet's hottest destination for the most eclectic sound and invigorating talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Joy in My House, inspirational reality radio show with a touch of recovery, a reality radio show where nothing is left unsaid.
And no one who says it is insignificant.
I'm here joined by my co-host, Lolita Robinson.
Hi, how are you today?
How are you doing today, Lolita?
Okay, I'm hanging in there like you.
Same here.
Weather things going on, you know, health problems, for praising the Lord, huh?
Yeah, definitely. I think a lot of illnesses is going around, a lot of viruses. Yeah. Yeah. But we want to thank you listeners and viewers out there for joining us today. If you're just getting out of service, we want to thank you for being part of the joy that we have in our house.
Yes.
We know that we feel very blessed and privileged to be a part of a show like this where we get to give back what was so freely given to us, and that is a safe place to grow spiritually and emotionally with one another.
Yeah, very true. I think Joy in My House today is pushing on when you don't feel like it.
That's right.
You know, I'm glad to be here, but, you know, it was kind of hard this morning.
I have to concur with you on
that. Yeah, I know you were saying that. And I think with you, you meet with people, don't realize that Joel every week meets personally with the people and has coffee. And you hear a lot of stories and you process a lot of things, and it brings up a lot of things for you.
You know what? I think that's what it is. I think a lot of our guests, we always say, you know, mm-hmm. it's a community. And, you know, that's our topic right now for the month at our church. And it does, through that community, we grow together, but it also takes a little bit of us to be vulnerable, and things do come up on our lives, and then we got to process them, and then we got to deal with our issues.
That's right.
And I think that's kind of what's been going on with me, a lot of emotional
growth. You've been growing a lot. You give me a lot of accolades, but I've had the pleasure to watch you grow in the Lord and watch you grow in recovery and to see the steps that you've taken. And it hasn't been an easy journey. So I've got to, you know, tell people that it's been a privilege for me too.
Well, thank you. I'm blessed. You know, mm-hmm. I every time we have a meeting, I always say how blessed I am to have these people in my life, like Paul, but like yourself. I mean, mm-hmm. you were the one that led me to Christ. I mean, if it wasn't for you and the way God placed you at that time in my life, I would not be here.
All glory go to him.
Yeah.
You know, same with me. Okay. So I'm excited.
We want to thank you for joining us here. If you're watching us on live, you can stream us live on newstream.tv. You can listen to us on iTunes Radio, genre R&B, or you can just tap in live here on latalklive.com. Now, if you want to link up with us and engage with us in this show, it's a community show. It's a platform, not a stage.
Right.
Please feel free to give us a call. The studio line is always open at 323-247-7443. Or you can send us tweets at twitter.com/joinmyhouse. Or follow us on Facebook /joinmyhouse for up-to-date lineups and info.
Right.
We had a great show last week. If you missed it,
you need
to catch the recap.
What? When the Lord said there is healing in laughter, you know, Brett was hilarious.
We had Brett Lewis from KFWB Sports Morning Radio come on and give his testimony of recovery. And what a joyful man for what he's gone through.
Well, yes, and it was like being on autopilot. I mean, he's been a radio host for like 40 years and all these different CBS and all over the whatever he's been doing. But it's just incredible. But he was also honest about what he went through.
I love
that when people tell us that.
I think it allows us to just have more trust when they're transparent. They're more real. They're more, I like to use the word tangible.
You know,
something that you can really pinpoint and say, you know, because of his recovery and his process and his submission, we're able to look at, oh, that was one of his bottoms. That was one of my bottoms. So he was a great guest.
He was a great guest. We've had so many. In fact, we weren't sure, you know, God has been so faithful, because we weren't sure that we were going to have a guest today, and boy, do we have a guest today.
Yes, today we're in luck today, ladies and gentlemen.
But we were going to do a recap, right?
Yeah, we're just going to do a recap of quite a few of our guests that have come on. But thanks to Paul, one of our board directors here, he got an opportunity to book Lee Ezell.
Oh my goodness.
She's an amazing speaker and author. If you haven't heard her, you need to. You can visit her website at www.leeezell.com. But she's going to come on the show
today. I can't wait.
And give some of her testimony and her her story.
Her whole story. And it's good to have Van Eric back. He wasn't feeling well last week.
We have Van Eric back as our producer.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you.
And Richard, thank you for, you know, sitting in. It was a great experience working with him. Yeah, he's like top dog, you know.
We want to thank you out there, listeners and viewers, for joining us and, again, being part of the joy that we have in our house. Paul always likes to say, one of our resident ministers here on our show, it's a decision. And today I'm deciding to be joyful. And to be honest with you, I am. We're very blessed to be here, to be a part of a show that gets to give back. But at the same time, to have such amazing guests come on the show.
I'm just when you just said minister. Lee was coming, I
remember.
What? What? We have Lee Ezell. Are you kidding? Praise the Lord. I mean, she's so humble and beautiful. But this woman has been internationally a speaker. And Paul, I just told him that the people that he has had chance to interact with, it just shows what kind of man he is. He's so humble.
Right. You wouldn't know it by
a good minister and everything. We're not just trying to push people up, but it does take a village. It's not just us here. The Lord has used so many components to do this. I'm just like, wow.
Right. And like you say, it has to be the Lord.
It's all
not anything that we've done. So we want to thank you out there for supporting us, for showing us your love. And again, engage with us as much as you can. We would love your feedback of what's going on in your lives and some of the praise that you have in your life. We would definitely love to share the joy that you have in your house. This is Joy in My House, ladies and gentlemen. Stay tuned. We're going to have Lee Ezell here as an in-studio guest. We'll be right back.
Okay. My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. Dare not trust sweetest frame, but wholly lean on Jesus' name. Who Christ the solid rock I stand. All other ground is sinking sand. All other ground, is sinking sand.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Joy in My House, inspirational reality radio show with the touch of recovery. I'm joined here by my co-host, Lolita Robinson.
Hello there, hello.
And our in-studio guest, Lee Ezell. Welcome to the show.
Yes, thank you. Yay. Good to be here.
What happened to the applause?
It didn't come on. Okay. Yay, there
we go. Get that phony applause. Good.
Yeah. Yay, thank you. Thank you, man.
I want to thank you for coming on the show, Lee. I know it was this week we weren't sure if we were going to have a guest, and we're outlining our show. And soon, sure enough, Paul calls us and says, you know what, I got a great guest, and she's able to make it this Sunday. Would you be able to fit her in? And we heard it was Lee Ezell. We said, definitely.
Definitely. Really, I'm serious. Thank you.
So I want to thank you for coming on the show. Now, I always like to mention how I met you. I met you through one of our board of directors here, Paul Obel, who does all of our marketing through Pro Advantage. He does our website. He does our marketing. He does Lolita's website as well, LRC Ministries. So he's been a big blessing to this show, Joy in My House, but to us personally as well, you know, being one of my mentors in my growth here in the Lord. So I met you through Paul. So So how long have you known Paul?
I've known Paul for a number of years. Mm-hmm.
We followed around in the same churches, and I really enjoy his beautiful testimony of him and his wife right. and the things he's been through in life.
Wow, well, thank you.
I don't want to talk to people that have had a perfect life.
Thank you. So
have never had anything happen to me. Okay. I live here in Orange County, and I have three wonderful children yes. and my husband. But, honey, I'm not talking to you. Thank you. I don't want help from you. You don't know what you're talking about. Thank you. You know?
Wow, it's so funny. I was listening to somebody today. I'm not going to say, and I just had to turn the radio off. It was so saccharine sweet. And I thought, Lord, forgive me. So I'm glad to know I'm not by myself.
That's right. No, no.
Well, thank then you're in the right place.
Yes, we are going to tell it.
That's right. Well, let's start off a little bit about your family of origin. Where did you grow up?
Philadelphia.
Wow.
Brotherly love, okay, man?
Same as our
city of brotherly
love. Homegirl. That's right.
Yeah. City of brotherly shove, right?
That's right.
Brotherly
exactly.
shove.
West
that's
Philly.
Right.
Brotherly born
shove.
And raised.
And I am a child of a couple of alcoholics, born and raised in the inner city area in Philadelphia, one of five unwanted girls.
Wow.
And we had a tough hoe to roll.
Okay.
A lot of domestic violence calls and all kinds of strange
wow.
things.
Wow.
And I couldn't understand why I had to grow up in that lousy atmosphere. Mm-hmm. It was miserable. But now I look back at it and I say, you know, I think that's the exact price I had to pay to become the person I am today.
Oh, that's a beautiful way of putting it.
And for God to be able to use me in different ways and with the struggles I've pulled myself through with his help.
Well, who was the drinker? Was it your father or your mother? Or
both of them.
Oh, boy. Wow. So you are.
They'd pour bourbon in my iced tea when I was a kid. Well, would you quit that?
You know, wow. or rub bourbon on your gums for children that were teething. Yeah, that was in our
that's
family.
That's how you get
yeah.
started.
Yeah, that's very true. Gosh.
So
you said there were five girls. There were no brothers.
No brothers.
Wow.
And no religion. Well, we sort of had a religious church. We went there on High Holy Days, and it was God's house. And I didn't have any concept of who God was, really, till somebody dragged me into my first real religious meeting. Preacher's name was Billy Graham.
Okay.
You heard of him?
Yes.
He's getting
that's
big
kind of familiar.
Now.
Yeah.
And had this meeting. I went in there, and that was the first time I ever heard the plane. Truth of God from the Bible. The dude is going down the line. It's not his personal philosophy that God does not have any grandchildren.
Right.
You do not get this from your parents.
Who took you to the meeting?
A relative. And I mean, I just made that simple decision of walking down and saying, okay, I remember when I did it. There was a little gal down there, kind of a counselor gal that was supposed to help me.
Right.
And she was so nervous. She was shaking with the Bible, trying to show me that. I said, honey, skip to the chase, okay? Because I already know where you're going. You got me in. I was up in the balcony. I'm down here. I'm signing up. Mm-hmm. What, do I make a pledge or how does it happen?
Oh, my goodness.
I know she was like, oh, my God, the person from hell. Why do I have to?
Because I have you've heard it all, right? You've probably seen it all. Every kind of scam. I hate to say that coming up in alcoholic families. You know, you can detest a lot of stuff, you know. So
that's
you
right.
want to just don't sugarcoat it. I just want to know what's up. Don't play games.
And it was hard to believe that the simple surrender I was being called to could have any effect on my life. But I'm telling you, that was the beginning of God growing within me. Not in God's house, but living inside of me.
Right on.
Because I surrendered to Christ. How, what a simple thing. He made it so simple by dying on the cross for us. Mm-hmm. And we make it so complicated.
Yeah, we do. People can't. They think they have to have something to do with it when it's just merely a gift. Absolutely. Mm-hmm. And I don't say merely, but you're right.
Mm-hmm.
So did it, was your conversion, as some people say, instantaneous, or was it a process for you?
A process for me, because I went home and I knew when I got off that subway, things were going to be different for me at home.
Mm-hmm.
And it was worse.
Oh, wow.
And I thought, well, I guess it didn't take.
Okay.
Because I didn't get it.
Well, was it because people maybe could see the difference in your spirit, or what?
No, just my home life wasn't any better. And I expected, I guess, God to be some kind of magician that bippity boppity boo, now everything is great. wonderful. No.
I'm glad you're saying that, though. I'm glad you're saying that. Because
yes. For myself as well, you know, when I gave my life to Christ, I thought, all right, things are going to be better. And just the opposite, things did get worse. Emotionally, it got more overwhelming. And I had to then surrender more. And it's like, well, I'm already surrendering. Shouldn't things get better yet? And no, it was this process that just felt that it was never going to end.
Yep.
But then sure enough, you start seeing the light at the end of the tunnel and one foot in front of the other. And you start, wow, it does work. You just have to really, in God's time and not in yours.
Well, he uncovers a lot of, when we come to the Lord, I used to tell people that I did a nosedive. That's not true. When you come to him, he reveals all of the problems and he starts moving and working in it. So do you feel like that was the experience with you, with your family?
Yes. And I was a teenager. As soon as I graduated from high school, man, I got on a bus. I came out here to California. I'd seen you beautiful California people out here. You look so good from a distance.
Thank you. Really, yeah, distance is my friend.
But no, it's people are the same all over.
That's right. Oh, you said California.
Yeah.
Right. When you got here, you saw that we weren't all the, you know, that's true.
That's right.
Everything
that's
you see true. On TV.
Would you come here for a showbiz career? Did you come out here to find your
to survive away from my family.
Okay, get as far
got
as
my first job up in San Francisco as a little typist. And there at the place where I worked, a man, salesman, whom I met in the morning, would rape me that night. As a virgin teenager,
what?
Oh, wow.
As a brand new Christian, I was like, no, this can't be happening.
What?
And I know there are events that happen in our lives we have no control over. We didn't deserve it, but bam, it hits us.
Right.
And that was how I started out my Christian life.
Oh, my, you must have really been like, Lord, where are you?
Hello. Yes.
Where are you? What is this about?
Really?
You know what? A pastor said a long time ago that, well, the children, I was molested as a child. But, you know, the enemy knows who God has. He knows who the Lord is going to use. So he goes right after with big guns. So it seems like that he came right after you. You too, Joel.
Yeah,
the big gums.
Yeah.
Well, I didn't know anything about the devil and God and all that stuff.
But looking back now, you see that he was probably trying to wipe you out.
And I thought that was bad enough. But when I found out I was pregnant as a result of that rape, I was like, it's time. Stop. Hold it. What's going on here? So I left the San Francisco area, came down here to L.A., and try to figure out my life.
Did you know anybody in L.A.?
I had some Shirtel relatives, and I thought, well, they could help get me started off. I didn't know what. A friend had talked to me about having an abortion. She said she'd helped her cousin get one. It was across the border in Mexico. She said it wasn't too bad. And I said, I just was too chicken. And I'm so grateful that there wasn't offered to me some nice-looking Planned Parenthood clinic someplace. Somebody could take me and get rid of this thing I didn't deserve. Was going to screw up my whole life. I'm grateful that easy option wasn't available to me. Because I have a lot of friends who've had abortions.
Yeah, we'd like to cover that one time. That's another show, because it's very painful for those who have had it, and it's very painful for those, because I've had a child out of wedlock, to keep the baby and to go through that. So your emotions must have just been like a blender. Yes.
Oh, yeah. But I figured out fast I was on my own. I had to find a way to make Jesus my father, my husband, my friend, my because that's all I was holding on to at that point.
Did you have a church there, down there at all, or what?
I found a church eventually.
Okay.
And I just would flip through the Bible trying to get direction. And the only thing I knew is thou shalt not kill. You know, I thought, gee, this baby isn't to blame. What, I'm going to give her the death penalty for the crime of her father?
Oh, wow. You had that presence of mind.
Come on.
You had
that presence doesn't make any sense.
Right.
So I thought, I will go through and I'll give this baby up for adoption at birth. And gave birth to a baby girl in an L.A. County hospital. In those days, birth mother had little or no rights, and I was just told, you'll be gone at 10:30, sign here, and that was it. I never saw the baby. I never helped. Nothing.
Wow.
And this
but they
was
did tell
like
you it was
the
a girl.
Biggest missing piece of my life.
Do you mind us asking how old you were at the time?
I was just turned 18.
Oh, boy. Wow. Boy. Boy, what an ordeal. Did you feel guilty? Were you
depressed?
But
I thought, you've got so many missing pieces in your that you don't have the answers for all these things.
And I can
so
see
just
that,
hang on to Jesus and go on.
And I can see that is the name of one of your books, The Missing Piece, the true story of a mother's painful loss of her daughter and her triumph reunion.
Yes.
Wow. What made you want to write the book?
Well, I was already in the writing Christian books groove, and I was sitting at home, minding my own business. I picked up the phone. Voice on the end of the phone says, "Hello, you've never met me, but you're my mother."
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, wow.
Lee.
What? I mean, I was shocked from my head to my feet, and here was this girl talking to me on the end of the phone, saying, "I've been searching for you for years." And she really had two motivations. First, she said, "I thought you'd like to know you're a grandma."
Oh, wow.
You have grandchildren here in Michigan. Because I had no idea, no clue where she'd gone or whatever. And she began to explain her second motivation for trying to seek me out and find me was to try to lead me to Jesus Christ on the phone.
Wow.
Not knowing that you already knew the Lord. Well, we went so much ahead. I mean, were you married at this point? Did you have other children?
Nope.
You never, so you're not married now? You never, did you ever marry?
I became a widow.
Oh, wow. Gosh, there's so much.
So she was the only child I ever had. And here she's trying to lead me, you know, she's trying to close a deal with Jesus on me. And I'm going, stop. excuse me. But I think you're trying to lead me to Jesus. She said, yeah. I said, well, you already did.
Oh,
see, you already did. More than 20 years ago. For truly, it was that experience in my life that would teach me to walk with God when life ain't fair. And life is not fair, friend.
It's not.
I don't know if you're old enough to know that or not. I just take my word for it. It's not fair. But God is just.
And that's the whole premise of this show. To have people, we've had people come on, drug addicts. We've had people come on who have been in car accidents. We've had people who have been in ministry. We've had people who have had all kinds of issues. But in the midst of it, there is help with God and that he is faithful and will take you through it. But she's right. I'm so glad you said it is not fair. It's not a cakewalk. And some guy on the radio I was coming over was really said he was disillusioned because we sell people this. If you come to Christ, your problems are gone. You know, God will give you a good mate. You'll have prosperity. And, you know, I'm sure there are those
fat
out there.
Chance.
I haven't met them. And everybody I've met is.
I think it's so true. Yeah. You know, people have this false expectation. And sometimes we got to take life as life is, not as we would have it.
Right.
And I think it's very important that we are realistic.
Right.
You know, to the reality of our situation and to life. Because I think we want to manipulate and control it the way we want it. And it's always in our time, in our way, not in God's time, in God's way.
Right.
And I've learned to have to really let go of that and just let God take control. Because that's a process in itself.
Yes, it is.
It really is.
Yep.
But it seems like you really had a lot of faith that God was working. That God was
your foundation. Well, I knew he would be faithful to keep that which I committed to him. I'd already run across that in the Bible.
Well, were you praying for this daughter? Were you praying for this child throughout all the, before she called you? Were you always thinking about her? You say a missing piece.
Oh, every birthday, baby shower, Christmas. Let's see, she's 2 years old now. She's, where is she? I mean, if you're adopted, you better know you were loved. You were not rejected. Your mother did the very best thing she thought she could for you, and that was to give you life and give you a start with a family. So I got to see her for the first time. Here she comes walking through this hotel room door. I can relive it. She has a baby in her arms. The first thing she says to me is, "Now go to your grandma."
Oh, wow.
That's amazing. Boy.
Wow.
Her husband stood there. Just like you rehearsed it, he said, "I'd like to shake your hand, Lee. I want to say thank you for not aborting Julie."
Oh, wow.
I don't know what our life would be like without her and the children. And together we would look at baby pictures.
But does she know the circumstances behind
She did. She
did her. What did her? Okay, what was her life like?
She was raised in a good home, had a good mom and dad, mm-hmm. and brothers, and no problems on
so
that.
So her
yeah.
adopted mother told her that your situation.
No, she found out playing with kids who had overheard some phone conversation. Say, nah, that's not your real mom, anyhow.
And, oh, wow. Know, that wow. Kids can be very cruel. They can be very, yeah. very, very cruel.
So she always felt she had a missing piece mm-hmm. in her life mm-hmm. and began that search for me. Wow. So we've had a wonderful reunion. I wrote the book, The Missing Piece, about it. And we did all the weird talk shows. And don't you wonder where they get those guests?
Yeah,
for those, right here. Right here, friends.
Well, how did the Lord open the door for that? I mean, were you writing books before your daughter came into your life?
Yes,
were
I
you
was.
Already, so what were you speaking on? Just hurt, alcoholism?
How to
or?
Improve relationships between okay. people.
All right, because of your
and
past.
I still specialize in that and do a lot of speaking, churches, and all kinds of settings on that.
So God really had already started it. The healing process in your life before he brought, I would imagine
yes.
there was a lot he had to deal with before he was going to have you open up. This
right.
can around with not camp. This beautiful blessing of your daughter. What did he do in towards of healing from your
well,
family,
I
your sisters?
I had to get his peace for my missing piece mm-hmm. in my life because I didn't know. Mm-hmm. Another one of those. What's it mean? Who knows? Who cares? It's just one of these random deals.
Right.
And so he is the God of missing pieces to me. Mm-hmm. He fills them in, and then when we turn our lives over to him. He brings in the, it's just remarkable.
And what he can do.
He's very influential, Lolita.
Yeah.
Oh, what a network. I'm telling
well,
you.
Well, I'm looking at it. You and Paul, I mean, my goodness.
Wow.
He really is. He really is, you know.
So is that what inspired you to write the book? But you already, like you said, you're already in the writing mode.
Yes.
And her coming back into your life, mm-hmm. that's what inspired you to write the book?
Yes, yes. And to talk about the principles that helped me be healed along the way without the magic missing piece. Mm-hmm. Because
well,
for some people, your missing pieces, they're not coming back.
Right.
Okay. It's a done deal.
Right.
It's over. That's the end of it. But you feel the holes in you. And I believe God, by the power of Christ, who died on the cross to fill your holes.
That's right. He did.
Is able to give you peace and purpose and meaning, even without knowing all the answers.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And he does bring the people in. You talked about, you know, you have a lot in the book, and I'm looking forward to, she gave me an autographed copy. Can you talk about some of those steps that God used towards healing? Was it people? Was it therapy? Mm. Or what were some of the elements he used
well,
to bring the
I'm
healing?
A shrink's... greatest thought to have me on the couch. Oh, what? This is 8 years, I'm telling you. I'm gonna milk her for 8 years. No,
okay.
I never had any counseling,
okay,
which I believe in, but
right.
I didn't happen to go that route.
Okay,
I think forgiveness was a big part
okay.
of beginning
for your family
my healing.
How about your family of origin? Your
and
dad,
for
your
the
mom?
Man who raped me.
Oh, gosh, yes,
wow.
right.
Now, he wasn't asking for it, I never saw him again, that was gone, but yet. Still, I knew Jesus said in Luke 11, if you do not forgive those who sin against you, you will not be forgiven.
Mm-hmm.
Write that down.
Mm-hmm.
That's kind of important. And I did it by faith, not mm-hmm. because I felt warm fuzzies.
That's it.
And no. Okay, you said it. I'm going to do it. That settles it. And it really began a work of grace mm-hmm. in me
wow.
to be able to do that.
And so your heart was to reach out to other people, obviously, when you started writing the books. I'm sure, have you met other people who've been in the same situation?
Oh,
rape
yes.
victims, rape victims.
Yes.
I mean, you have so much. Alcoholism, you know, being a rape victim, a person who has given up a child. I mean,
right.
You no wonder the lines are long. You can, you know, I thought about that too. Some of the experiences that I've gone through and all of us have. So it's like having a big bag now. I look back and I can dig in
right.
and come up with these experiences.
Bingo.
Is that how you know?
Bingo.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes when I tell my story about my daughter, I get into the area of the endangered species. Because California, that's very big.
Right.
I mean, we raise millions of dollars for the wolves and the caribou and the whales and the California condor. That's right. The biggie
right
now. Right. That's a biggie. And I have a friend who works at the UCI Endangered Species Program. And he loaned me for today.
Wow. Here's the props.
California condor egg. This thing is huge. I'm so scared to be carrying it around. Millions of dollars are raised to save this. Have you ever seen the California condor? I mean, the ugliest, vultury looking.
Oh.
God made a mistake on that one.
Wow.
But we still got it.
Oh, wow.
But anyway, everybody is so, save them, save them. And I know that if I were to do this.
there went my teeth.
If I were to do this to the condor egg, this is a felony in the state of California.
It's right not real.
Now, the cops are coming in the door because, you know, of course I can kill a baby. Right. No, that's my right. It's not convenient.
Wow.
And, dear God, what's happened to us?
Wow.
Now, I got to confess, this was just an empty ostrich egg. Okay, it wasn't any condor egg, mm-hmm.
but it was
point made.
Mm-hmm. Right. Our lives are like that. That has to go for your
talk about missing pieces, huh?
Wow. And people don't put in, you know what you're saying. Well, what I'm hearing is that people put a lot of money into missing pieces or keeping eggs, but what about people's lives?
Right.
What human about people's beings. Lives and people's, you know, humans and what's going on. And this is what you've been, you know, I can just see it in your eyes. There's so much I want to ask you, but I know people want to read the book, but I just admire your forthrightness and your honesty and your strength.
Because I'm a wounded warrior.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't get hold by just magically mm-hmm. going to some shrink or something. No,
right.
No. Right. I had to fight for every inch that I got.
Right.
And I got stronger every inch that I fought. Mm-hmm. It was part of the healing process. You know that, Joelle.
Yeah, through the process, you do. You get stronger. You get your foundation grows, I think, especially when you have Christ incorporated. I know in sobriety, you know, you get stronger in sobriety.
Mm-hmm.
But when you're faith-based and you're Christ-based, you get stronger in ways that you can't even imagine you'd be. I can't imagine where I am today, where I was 5 years ago.
Right.
If it wasn't for Christ's foundation and His grace. His grace allows me to feel like, you know what, I can go another day. Where sometimes without that grace, I don't think I'd get up in the morning.
No.
And I think it's very important that we talk about that forgiveness and that grace that God gave us, that we also need to give as
mm-hmm.
well.
Mm-hmm.
You talk about forgiveness and you talk about forgiving other people, and it's so
sometimes we got to forgive ourselves too, which is something you've been talking about.
I'm in the process of
forgiving yourself,
forgiving myself and my shame and my guilt.
Mm-hmm. Beautiful.
Yeah, so I commend you. Same mm-hmm. like Lolita, I have to.
And not only forgiving yourself, but a lot of people have to forgive God. Because
mm-hmm.
God's a fall guy. He goes, why did God let me have this car accident? Why did God?
Right.
And God, you know, poor God's going, hey, honey, I was there to help you. Mm-hmm. I didn't make it happen.
Mm-hmm. You know? That's
we very forget
true.
That the Bible says a third of the demon angels were thrown down to this planet. Hello. We have a few problems because of that.
Yes,
you
we
add
do.
Sin on top of that and all the other things. It's no wonder we're in the mess we're in. And God didn't do it. The earthquakes, they're not acts of God. They're an act of Mother Nature. Come on. Father God is there to heal you after these earthquakes and shock waves that go through our lives. He's the good guy.
Yeah, he is, but we don't understand him.
And I think you mentioned that in your book where you talk about, so who's to blame for life's unfairness?
Mm.
And I think it's important to touch on that because we tend to blame God right mm-hmm. away. First one we blame is God.
Yes.
Why did you do this to
mm-hmm.
me? Why
That's
am I in this
right.
situation?
And we think God is punishing us. That goes right along with blaming God. Well, I deserve it. I'm probably paying for my sins. No, you cannot pay for your own sins.
That's right.
Sorry.
That's right.
That's why Jesus died. No. The most important thing about punishment when a parent punishes a child is that they have to know the reason they're being punished. or else it's not. We don't know the reason these things happen to us. No, no.
He's not a God of condemnation. He's
from our Father God. No, no.
But I think sometimes that we go through these things because he uses them. Because there is so much pain in life. There is. I think there's far more people that are broken than have had hardship than people who've had silver spoon experiences. So I feel honored to the point where I could use some of the experiences that I've gone through to encourage other people. We can't fix them, but we can encourage them to keep on.
It's such an honor that you had all this crap happen to you in your life, you know, right?
Yeah, now.
You
now.
Could die from such a blessing, you know, huh? Yeah. Come on!
I think that's a great point. Yeah, you can die from such a blessing.
Yeah.
But God is able to turn those situations around for his glory.
Right.
And like you said, Lolita, to encourage other people.
Yeah.
And to become a witness to the work that God is able to do.
Yes.
Because I know for me, I did the opposite. When my life started getting chaotic, I did the opposite. I got more involved in my acting out and my alcoholism and all that. Instead of leaning more towards Christ, I detach myself more.
There's a good point. A lot of people run and pull away. Good point.
Most people, I would say the majority of people, I would almost say all the people, tend to run away. And you actually did the opposite. You actually started building more a foundation in Christ and having more faith in him.
Yes.
And I think that's also why he's now using you. And your story, I mean, thank you for coming on the show and being so transparent about your story, because I think it's important
for
people
more
to hear.
We got more to hear.
Because I'm not something special. I'm some kid from the other side of the tracks that had a hard road to hoe. Big deal. Mm-hmm. You know? We can all be made whole because Jesus paid the price for it on the cross.
Yes,
that's what we're talking about when Easter's coming up here. It's all about that focus. And God isn't going to ask you when you get up to heaven, how much money did you give the church?
Right.
How
many awards you have.
No, he's just going to say, what did you do with my son, Jesus Christ?
That's right.
That is a great message now coming up on Easter.
Right.
We're going to take a quick commercial break here at Joy in My House. We're joined here by Lee Ezell. I want you to find her on Facebook, /Lee Ezell. You can also find her on her website at www.leeezell.com. She's a speaker and an author of quite a few books. Check out her website. Give her some love and support. Send her some messages. I want to thank you for coming on the show. We're going to come right back, and we're going to go to our conclusion of Joy in My House, ladies and gentlemen. Stay tuned.
Yeah, come back. All right.
No doubt the landlord's waiting, can't pay my rent again this month. There has been war debating, missile attacks are awaiting.
Do you suffer from degenerative diseases such as high blood pressure, diabetes, fibroid tumors, high cholesterol, genital herpes, or a plethora of other diseases that rob you of a quality life? If so, then visit the website of herbalist Tahuti Ma'atra at dhealthstore.com and open the door to natural healing at an affordable price. dhealthstore.com has over 1,800 products created by herbalist Tahuti Ma'atra, specifically designed to help you heal the natural and safe way. At dhealthstore.com, you'll find everything from herbal formulas and cleanses, such as Tahuti's famous Full Body Detox, as well as herbal teas, extracts, natural body butters, lotions, creams, children's products, hair care products, and of course, sexual enhancement products for both men and women. So visit the website of Tahuti Ma'atra, dhealthstore.com, or call toll free at 1-888-823-9416. dhealthstore.com.
Are you ready to enjoy the Maui lifestyle? You can have it all by owning real estate on the Paradise Island of Maui. Dennis Rush, a 22-year Maui resident and real estate broker, brings his wealth of experience and market knowledge to add value to your Maui real estate understanding, providing a level of service as unique and exceptional as the island of Maui itself. The magical island of Maui was voted the most exclusive resort island in the world by Condé Nast Traveler, and keep in mind, Maui is only a simple non-stop flight away. Hawaii Business Magazine Top 100 Realtors awarded Dennis Rush the 2011 fourth top realtor on the island of Maui. Go to www.dennisrush.com to view all of the amazing properties currently available in the Maui MLS system. Whatever your needs or desires, Dennis Rush will provide a private consultation for any Maui properties your heart desires. You will be in good hands. Once again, go to www.dennisrush.com. That's www.dennisrush.com. Contact Dennis today to start your Maui lifestyle now. Dennis Rush, proud sponsors of the Dawn Christie Show and LA Talk Live.
No weapon formed against me.
Welcome back to Joy in My House, ladies and gentlemen. I'm joined here with my co-host, Lita Robinson.
How are you, everybody? Glad you came back.
And our in-studio guest, Lee Ezell. Lee Ezell, we want to thank you once again for coming on the show and sharing with us your story.
Sure.
I hope that you out there who are listening and viewing are being engaged. I hope that some questions are being stirred up in your lives. Lee is able to have the opportunity to come and share with us some of her tragedy, but through that tragedy, some of her hope and how God is able to change any circumstance, mm-hmm. any circumstance for His glory. Lee, we wanted to touch base with you. I think Lolita had a couple questions for you that were very intriguing to me.
About your daughter. I mean, her experience. Okay, she called you on the telephone and obviously you met. And what was the experience like for her seeing her mother? Was there any anger towards you or?
There wasn't. And mm-hmm. I was so glad to see that because I was ready to address it. Mm-hmm. But she said, no, you did, I think, what God wanted you to do. Mm-hmm. I was supposed to be in my family I grew up in.
Wow.
And then He made it possible for us to meet and everything fit together in her thinking. Mm-hmm. You know, there wasn't that. That's why I think adoptees need to be told mm-hmm. they were not rejected.
No, you're right. Not.
They're loved, yes.
I think that is a very valid point.
Yeah, for a woman to carry a child that far, and also to give grace for the women who did not have the support or felt the need to go the other route. We don't want to judge and condemn in any way.
Right.
But we're talking now to people who have been adopted, for a woman to carry the child and to have that child stir and move and yet to be able to hand it over, that is an act of love.
And I've had friends who've had abortions.
Yes.
And they are victims themselves.
Yes, they are.
Because
they are.
I've had more than... I didn't know it was a baby. They told me it was not a baby. And they feel totally ripped off.
They do. I'm sure they do.
And I know that Jesus died on the cross for their forgiveness mm-hmm. and their wholeness, even without having that baby
in
their arms.
Right. That's right.
And I did want to ask, did your daughter have any resentment or just anger towards her father?
She was dealing with it. Mm-hmm. And I remember telling her, hey, if you want, should I search? I said, hey, honey, your origin is your birthright. If you want to search, go ahead. But she felt that she was satisfied with what she found.
Right. And she decided not to open that
closed.
Up.
Those closed,
yeah. Right. Good. Wow. That's excellent. That's
what. Well, it seems like there was... Ahead,
yeah, how did you guys start ministering together? And then you're going to go to the next session because I want to hear also about you're a widow. I'm a widow too.
Oh,
so
okay.
We have a lot. I don't have those things in common with you, but hurt and pain, I understand.
Okay.
Yeah.
Good.
So how did you guys start ministering
together?
You're
my girl.
You're
my
girl. I was telling her, well, you know, he's really tracking because we're a little further down the road, you know, in terms of having a chance to process this and you're still processing a lot of your stuff, so.
I get to be here.
Yeah. Are you saying we're old?
No.
Are you telling him we're old?
Season. No, season, ladies. You know, in our walk with God.
Yeah. Okay. I got it.
Well, for me, I think I'm just privileged. I think I'm privy to be sitting in a lot of our guests are mm-hmm. so much further down the road, especially on their walk with Christ
and walk with the Lord. That's what I was talking about. Yeah.
And I get to witness to that. It allows me to feel humbled and be like, you know, I like how far I've come, but I know that this is just one step. I still have further to go.
Right.
And Lolita always says, you don't arrive. You know, it's a process and it's a lifelong process. It's a lifelong, not commit. I don't want to even say commitment, lifestyle. This is my lifestyle. So I'm privy to be here today and, mm-hmm. and humbled to have people like Lolita in my life and then to have guests such
like
as yourself
right.
come and minister to me. So thank you. But I did want to ask you, I wanted you to talk about, your quest for finding the purpose in pain. I thought that was such a great question to ask.
Yes. Well, I have learned that seeking the purpose in pain can be pretty fruitless and very frustrating. Mm-hmm. Because, you know, if God were to try to explain to us, okay, now here is why this happened, it would be like a rocket scientist talking to a two-year-old and trying, and we couldn't get it anyway. That's we right. couldn't process no. it anyway.
Right.
So I have learned to, instead of seeking the purpose in pain, seek the presence of God in your life. Mm-hmm. That alone makes up and fills in a lot of the frustration and the questions in your life, so that you're not always, well, I got to find out if I only knew. No, give it up. Mm-hmm. Give it up. Mm-hmm. And maybe God will give you something better in its place. He did me.
Mm-hmm. That's awesome. Well, you want to touch on a little bit about being a widow? So you got married in the process. Where did your husband fit in all this? Where'd you meet him?
Oh, he was such a doll. He always wanted to search for her. And I said, no, the way I left it with God was, I'm going to commit her to you. If you want us to meet, you'll have to do the math, because I'm not going to interrupt someone's life and say, I'm the real mother.
That's true.
Right. No, look, her mother is her mother.
Her mother, yes.
And when we went on talk shows after we were reunited,
did the mother go?
We
her
took
mother go
her
with
mother.
Oh, wow. Now,
come
that's
on, you got two
pieces.
Mothers. Let's right. be realistic about this.
Mm-hmm. Wow. So where did you meet your husband? I mean, where was he in all this? You met him?
I met him at a Bible conference.
Oh.
And he had some missing pieces in his life, too. His first wife had died of blood cancer.
Oh, boy.
And his second wife died of brain cancer.
Oh, who?
So I remember when he asked me, would you like to be number three?
I'm like, oh,
no. There's something wrong with you, bud. Don't touch me. I don't want anything to do with it. And we had just such a beautiful, long marriage.
How
and
long
then
were you
he
married?
Passed away with cancer. Oh. 25 years.
Wow. How long ago was this that he passed?
15 years.
Okay.
Wow. All right. Has some wonderful grandkids out there.
So he didn't get a chance to meet your daughter? His
yes,
daughter. Did he meet? He got a chance
did.
To meet her?
Yes, before he died.
Wow.
So that was really great.
That is beautiful.
Yeah.
That is awesome how God brought that. When we're talking about missing pieces, you know, there was so much that was covered here. There might be some of you out there who have been raped. There may be some of you out there who have come from alcoholic families. We kind of touched over that, but that within itself, I know we want to have a show dedicated to that, you
right.
know, because I had two parents who had alcoholism, and I understand there's a lot of missing pieces. You lose your childhood,
right?
A lot of broken dreams. I know I sabotaged a lot of things that could have been that are not because of my emotional bringing.
Right.
What other kind of missing pieces of women that you've come in contact with since you've been?
Oh, broken relationships, mm-hmm. lost so many things. Mm-hmm. Like men and women, everybody.
Right, men.
And there's not always going to be some marriageic person come in your life. Bingo! No. I'm a realist.
Mm-hmm.
I know that life is tough mm-hmm. and life ain't fair. I've
That's
already
right.
accepted that.
Right.
But where do we get the idea that our life was supposed to be fair?
I don't know. I guess from the movies.
Well,
I guess. The propaganda.
It's like, no, fair for my life is everything going wrong. No ups and downs. No interruption. No surprises. I'm sorry. That's not realistic.
No, I don't think so.
Not at all.
That's you know, there's a talk show host I love. I listen to him, Dennis Prager. And he said,
yeah.
You know, Dennis said his friend, I think it was his best friend's mother, said the only happy people that she knew were people that she did not know. And I had to think about it. And I thought, you know, that's true.
That's a great one.
I love it because, you know, it's true. We all have this concept, you know.
We all have this expectation, I think,
right.
and it's propagated by television and they glamorize.
Yes.
But they never really show the background of what happens with all the acting out or what the reality, I guess, is the reality of what life really is. But I think these struggles make us, like you said, who we are, and it allows us to depend on God more. I mean, some of us go the other route like I did in my youth, where I depended more on my acting out to give me that validation, that substance.
Yeah.
But that God-shaped hole, the only thing that could fit in that God-shaped hole was Christ himself.
You know what? I was at my Bible study this week, and I didn't read it, but my pastor's wife read it, and another lady somewhere in the post, Jim Carrey, of all people, had a quote. He was saying, I wish all of you were famous. I wish all of you had a lot of money. I wish all of you had the accolades that those of us that you look up to have aspired to. Then you will see it does not fulfill. And they shared that in the Bible study. It does not bring happiness. It does not bring you what you think it is. So, like you were saying, life has its, even if you have those perks to go along with it. Like I tell people, I think if you're rich, you can be depressed in Hawaii. But you're still,
that's right.
You're still going to, you know.
And Lady Gaga does not have it made.
No.
No, I don't want to do it.
No. So you're right. Life is not fair. What do you do with it? That's what your thing is, to find the purpose in how to get through it?
Yes. How to get through it. Not the ultimate, I want to understand, philosophic. I give it up. Mm-hmm. Come on. Mm-hmm. You need peace to live. You need joy to live. You need things that only the Spirit of God can give you. And he's certainly willing and standing up there waiting to give it. He isn't the one who's reached down and slapped you with his. No, God's hands don't wound you, but they're wounded hands.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Hands of a man who once said, "My God, why have you forsaken me?" And those nail-scarred hands were for our healing, emotionally, physically, mental, and in every single way. Mm-hmm. I believe that with all my heart.
I do, too. I don't know how people do it without the Lord. I don't. I really don't. I mean, it is so, oh, my gosh, it's so despairing. Everything you turn around on the TV is just, it's appalling. But there is hope.
There is. I have to concur with you. That peace that I have now because of Christ being my foundation. When I go to bed at night, and I lay my head on the pillow, I actually rest. Where before I tossed and turned and I couldn't sleep and had all this anxiety and all this frustration. Mm-hmm. Now when I go to bed, I actually get a good night's sleep. You know, even though I have stressful things, but I've learned to surrender that and say,
without a sleeping pill?
It was no sleeping pill.
Wow. All right, man.
Well, she mentioned the word joy. I think it's a segue for you.
Yeah, you know, the premise of the show, the name of the show is Joy in My House. And we always like to ask that of our guests. What does joy in my house mean to you, Lee? I know through all your struggles, you know, joy in my house.
To me, I would say I think that joy is the most infallible sign of the presence of God. Mm-hmm. And when I lose my joy, I know I'm in trouble. Mm-hmm. And I know where to go. And I go back to the place where I've had joy. I check the, you know, just give yourself a checkup. Mm-hmm. Because that, I couldn't live without that. Mm-hmm. That joy and expectation inside. It's very important. And Jesus said, "I came that your joy would be full." He's not a sour boy. You know, you see those pictures of Jesus. Oh, he looks so pitiful. I wouldn't even want to meet him. You know?
Little old
what sort of a poor pooped thing. But now, how come we didn't get a good picture of him when he was here? You know? Smiling out on the fishing boat and having fun with his friends.
And with the kids and stuff.
When
you know, he
that?
Is funny. I tell the story. I was traveling with Debbie Boone years ago, and I was in Vegas when the Aladdin Hotel was there. That's how long ago.
Yeah.
But I was in, I was in Miami. I was in Miami. Anyway, we were on the 22nd floor, and I thought it was funny. So what I did was, when I got out of the elevator, I pressed every single button so that the person who got in, well, lo and behold, the next day, we were late. I was running late. And when I got in that elevator by myself, every single button had been pushed. And every time I stopped on the floor, I could just hear God laugh. And I thought, okay, Lord.
It's a God joke on you. It is. Yeah.
I never did it again.
That's a great story. That's funny.
It's true. It's really true.
Yeah, I think joy, I think God really allows us to be joyful.
Yeah.
He gives us the opportunity.
It's not happiness. What's the difference, do you think, with happiness? Did happiness come in women and drinking? And what do you think? Well,
yeah, I think happy. You can make yourself think you're happy,
right,
through these things. But joy is something I think that comes from the heart. It's so deep. It's so multi-layered. It's not something that is surface like happy. Yeah, I can be happy. But I mean, just like a cake. Your birthday's here. You have this cake. You blow it out. You're happy. But to know that your family's there, to know that, you know, you feel that peace, that oh, that's joy to me. Mm-hmm. It's so deep. I mean, like I look at my puppy and
loves that puppy.
I love
that.
I'm gonna get you a wife. I'm sorry,
Suki. We love you, but
well, yeah. Well, right now, Suki. Right now, when she just comes and gets excited when I get home, mm-hmm. and I feel that joy inside my heart that this dog loves me unconditional.
Yeah,
blesses me. Mm-hmm. And I think to me that's real joy.
And that's how God looks at us.
But it comes from God. Because I think if I was acting out and still doing my craziness in my life, I wouldn't be able to feel that. I'll be so detached. So God gives us the opportunity to feel joy, but we got to decide to take it. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Just like His grace, just like His love.
Receive.
We got to be able to receive it.
Well, what is your daughter's name?
Her name is Julie.
Julie. Well, Julie, I haven't had a chance to meet you, but your mother is awesome. You have to be. And God bless you for not having a hard heart.
Right.
And bringing your babies to meet their grandmother and acknowledging the mother that God gave you here also. What a wonderful, wonderful story.
Yeah, she's pretty neat.
Well, and you are too. And, you know, your book, I can't wait to read it. And how you talk about not trying to figure it out. That I'm walking away with that.
Come on.
Paul talked about that too. Come on. Let's just leave it, you know. Don't try and figure everything out. You can't.
Yep.
Lee, I want to thank you for coming on the show. Thank you for your transparency. Thank you for your story.
For your story.
Now, you can find Lee Ezell at www.leeezell.com. You can find her book, The Missing Piece. She has several other books, and she's a speaker.
Oh, yeah. You might want to...
And an author.
Share some of them.
Some of the books that she has, actually. These titles include The Cinderella Syndrome, which I thought was great. The Missing Piece, Pills for Parents in Pain.
Oh, yes.
Ooh. Finding God When Life Is Not Fair. Mm-hmm. These are just a few of her books, but find her on Facebook leeezell.com and engage with her. Thank you for coming on the show. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Paul. And fan, good to see you again as always.
We want to thank all you listeners and viewers out there. Thank you for joining us today. Please feel free to engage with us on joinmyhouse.com/Facebook. You can tweet us directly at twitter.com/joinmyhouse. And you can find all of our archive shows on www.latalklive.com. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Join My House. You guys have a blessed day.
Take care. See you next week.
Bye.